Hey everyone, welcome back into Wizards Media Day. Everyone is on Twitter right now using the hashtag WizMediaDay, telling us what they want to know from the players that we're going to be chatting with all day long. Jumoke Davis here with me. Now we have another guest sitting down with us, Martell Webster. How's it going, Martell?
I'm good. I'm glad to be here.
I'm glad to have you here too.
Always,
especially the hair.
That's reassuring.
Especially
yeah, the hair's got to make a statement today.
It's pretty awesome.
Has a couple things to say.
Okay. What does he want to say first?
Don't worry. Don't worry. We'll get into that.
Okay.
He kind of just chimes in when he wants.
Okay. All right.
Now, we had Martian sitting down with us earlier, and he's kind of going for the same look that you have. I mean, he's a couple months of growth behind you, but I think he's gunning for what you're sporting now.
It's like 14 strong months right here.
Yeah.
14.
Yeah.
Are you in favor of that, or do you want to kind of have your own signature look on the court?
Hey, I mean, as long as he's comfortable with wearing it, that's all that matters.
Maybe you can get the whole team to do it.
I'm not going to go out
Jumoke,
my way.
Don't encourage that.
Okay. Frohawks, but if they want to, join the team.
You know how, like, the Caps would grow those playoff beards?
Yeah, yeah.
A little mohawk.
That's a hockey fixture. Let's keep the different hairstyles in
mohawk.
The NBA.
Okay. Let's
You're
get
an
to basketball.
We'll stick with that. Last I checked in with you, you spent some of the summer in Portland. You're rehabbing from your back surgery. You said you were feeling good. What are you up to now?
Same thing. You know, it's a tedious regimen, but it's for the better. You know, just being cognizant of the fact that health is the staple in this league. Without it, you can't be very successful. So I have a very good rehab regimen with the training staff here that we've been attacking every day. And I can tell you that I'm ahead of schedule, and I'm looking forward to getting back and helping this team win.
Are you doing, like, yoga, stretching? I remember you were over at Capitol Hill with Hayley promoting, you know, working on your back and back health. Just
Can't quite do yoga yet, but lots of stretching, lots of functional movement. And that's all, you know, courtesy of these guys here in the training staff, Thomas, Naveen, and Eric Waters, just really being behind me and being a catalyst of, you know, promoting good health and me getting here every day and holding me accountable for, you know, for this regiment and me getting back. So that's where all the thanks go to, you know, and I'm ahead of schedule, and I'm, like I said, I'm looking forward to getting back and helping this team.
Now, on a lighter note, we kind of looked through your Instagram, social media. We know you visited the Nice Cream Factory.
That was a fun day.
Yes, the Nice Cream Factory. That's my brother's company. It's in Clarendon. Wonderful company, delicious ice cream. If you find yourself in that area, please come out there and enjoy the ice cream.
Now, what's special about it? I walked in there myself.
All local and organic ingredients. Their niche is that they freeze the ice cream on the spot with liquid nitrogen, so it's a cool experience for kids to enjoy. So if you ever go up there, I mean, please bring your kids if you have them so that they can enjoy the experience. It's a wonderful place to be, hang out, and just enjoy great ice cream.
And grown-ups, too.
Grown-ups, too.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it was pretty cool. But then you also had the dog. You took the selfie with your dog. What is that, a mix?
It's a Catahoula. I actually saved
her.
Catahoula is the name.
Catahoula.
I don't know if I may not be giving that name justice, but I'm pretty sure it's Catahoula. She's a farm dog. Her name's Cassie, and we saved her from the Oregon Humane Society, and she's been part of my family for six years now? I call her my second baby. So my oldest daughter, then Cassie, then my two youngest right after her. So, yeah.
You took pretty low to take that picture. She
takes great pictures.
So does it mean anything? Are you excited that you can say you're a 10-year vet?
Yeah, of course. I mean, but at the end of this contract, you know, I would have beat the odds four times. They say the average career is 4 years in this league. And the fact that I have a chance to play in this league for 12 years is pretty amazing. Three times, my fault. To say that I've been able to play in this league for 12 years is amazing, but to get to 10 is amazing in itself. Not many people can do that or have the chance to do that, and I'm very grateful of that. So, you know, every day I wake up with a smile on my face knowing that, you know, I could be somewhere else or my life could have turned out completely different. So being able to wake up knowing that I have a steady job at, you know, very fortunate to be paid the amount of money that I'm paid to play this game. I can't complain, so I have no complaints for my career. Been here 10 years. Woohoo. And I'm super excited and thankful for that.
We know you do a great job off the court taking care of yourself. What would you attribute your longevity to?
I couldn't hear that.
Say what would you attribute your longevity to? Just, you know, your rehab regimen, your post-game, pre-game, warm-ups.
I would say it's all for the love of this game. You know, I started playing this game. I've been playing since I was 12 years old. And, you know, starting off not being very good at the game of basketball, but having a passion to want to get better. So, you know, and the years that I've been able to play in this league and at this level, I attribute just to the love of the game.
Now we're going to send it over to Jeremy at our social media hub. Fans want to ask you some questions using the hashtag WizMediaDay. Jeremy, what are fans saying? What do they want to know from Martell?
All right, Martell, you've built a lot of fans here in D.C. over a couple of years, and they've heard some of your impressions. They've heard some singing. Can you do anything for us, maybe a 15-second bit, an impression of anyone on the team that you'd like to do?
Please.
You know, I save all my material for the regular season, once the regular season starts. You know, that's just the way it is. Don't ask me why, but I have some Glenn Rice Jr. that you guys will love to hear, but it's coming soon. I'm not ready to give it to you yet, but you will get it. I promise, new material for the entire year.
What about last year? We were in Madison Square Garden after the game. You were singing something.
I was singing
Willy Wonka?
Yeah,
or?
Yeah. Was it Pure Imagination?
Yeah, yes, it was. That's what
I love
was.
That song.
Would you say you're a higher pitched? What is that alto soprano for females then?
Is it tenor or is it? It's alto.
Would you be a tenor? How would you describe yourself?
I think a tenor. Tenor.
I don't know music.
Range.
I don't know that the actual terms and or what it is, but at a higher pitch, I would say.
Okay.
And I can sing and give you a little bit of low, too.
Okay.
Whatever the terminology is, but
so yeah, you have some range, yeah.
And you're
very diverse.
Anthem, right? You did a national anthem with
but
Garrett.
But I can
Temple.
Only do that with Garrett.
With Garrett, that's it.
My right
we
got
to get
man.
Him back over here. Where's Garrett? Oh, he's not here.
He's warming okay. up. He's getting the pipes ready. Is it, so yeah. You better go do the same. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. If we get Garrett here, then I'll sing for you guys.
Okay. Maybe
perfect.
Next time. Maybe
so
next
we're
time.
Teasing that for this season. Stay tuned. Martell's going to sing for you at some point, so make sure you're paying attention.
Don't
guys, keep using the hashtag WizMediaDay if you have more questions. If you want to encourage Martell to use his pipes, maybe he'll post a video or something later. Give us a little
give
taste.
Give me hair tips, too. Hair tips.
Hair tips,
yes.
Definitely.
I'll be chatting with you about that later.
I know. I kind of spoke for him.
Okay.
A lot of that was, you know, him living vicariously through me. So, okay. Yeah, okay. You got it, though.
Okay.
All right, guys. Thank you so much, Martell. We're going to let you go on about your day. You have a ton of stuff to get to. Guys, keep using that hashtag, WizMediaDay. We're going to take a quick break. On the other side of this break, we'll have someone else joining us.